Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Overwatch. It is first game of the night. They are playing, I believe, Stony Brook University. And the first map here is Blizzard World. So, yeah. Tonight I have a friend and other caster with me. Go ahead and say hello, Rudy.
How are you? I'm Rudy.
So, looks like LR will be defending first here, and we will see them coming out shortly.
Yeah. A little bit of a different starting lineup tonight for them. The Bears, I mean.
Alright. So, tonight, playing, I don't believe... I don't believe that we have seen Sean play this year. Sean9093. I don't think he's played this year so far.
I don't think so either.
But he is a... Typically, I've seen him play tank. And we will see how this goes with Andy not playing tank, but Andy playing DPS this time.
Indeed. In fact, I think they have two different tank players tonight. Azrim is usually a tank player on the side, as well as Sean playing tank.
So there have yet to be anyone killed yet on either side here. There goes a Moira ult going out.
Very quick ult for the Bears right there from Moira's.
And LR takes out both tanks and their Ashe. Deshaun does go down. But it looks like LR will fend off this point from them getting to this point.
Mm-hmm. It'll be interesting to see if the Ana nanos the Rein here to try to get onto the point, get some early cap going, or if they'll wait and see if they use it with Bob. Because the Bears are lacking in ults right now in terms of being able to fend off an ult push. While as the enemy team has three ults, two of which just popped, or no, just...
Yep, looks two. Like Bob just came out.
Yeah.
Yep.
Good transcendence for the Bears, but...
They just got wiped out by that Ashe and...
Yes,
by
did.
That Reaper ult. Reaper ult there got four coupled with the Ana.
Yeah.
It looks like LR is just going to be able to spawn right before their spawn moves.
Which is good. That does allow them to stop the payload early and get this first.
Gives them a bit of advantage. I really hate these controls.
Looks like Moira's going to have her ult again very quickly before even... three of the other players.
Yep. That's the thing with Moira as a character. She just charges her ult so quickly.
She really does.
And it looks like there's a little bit of an Ana, or not Ana,
Ashe.
Ashe battle going on over here, and Andy takes out the enemy Ashe.
Pretty good aim for Badger there to hit that shot.
There goes Orion ult. I think he got one off that. Bob gets one. Looks like Reaper might be coming back.
They do lose Inyana. Oh, they lose both healers here, so...
Yeah, looks like all of LR went down yet again there.
Yeah. Team wiped.
Really, really good teamwork there by Stony Brook.
Mm-hmm.
Calling out that Reinhardt ultimate.
It makes you wonder if the, if the lineup changes for the Bears are affecting their teamwork at all.
That is a question to ask.
Looks like Badger goes down from the Reaper on the left there.
So does Boop. Goes down from the Ashe.
Mm-hmm.
Zurum goes down. So does Olivia and Sean. Is that everybody off of LR's team?
Very close.
Yep, there goes Deku.
Yep.
So here we go into the final push phase of this map, I would call it.
Yeah.
Into this room here.
To be fair, this map is it is fairly easy to push the payload on this map once you.
Yeah, that is true.
But
usually
once you get
the,
here,
the end of the battle happens right here.
Yeah.
This is where it's make or break.
Indeed.
Generally.
If they lose this first corner fairly easily, then they'll be in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Because the enemy team still has over 4 minutes to go.
And I think that Reaper is going to jump down on top of him here in just a second. Yep, there he goes.
And there's the damage from the ult coupled with the Zarya ult, looks like. But decent ult from the friendly Moira, but
I don't know if that will be enough to keep the bears alive here.
It looks like they're just going to get a free pass right to the point.
Oh, Zenyatta's going to use his ult to get back to the point very quickly.
That's a good use of his ult.
Trying to keep it alive just a little bit for LR.
Yeah, give them time to respawn and get on, push it back, and just hopefully get a couple of picks here. They've isolated the Ashe and the Lucio.
Olivia goes down to Bob.
Oh, man.
That Bob had just put in a lot of work there right at the end.
Yeah, it did.
I think it took out 4.
That didn't really look like a very good round for the Bears there.
It happens. We've seen it happen before.
Of course.
They've been able to turn it around pretty quickly.
Well, and as we said before, this map's pretty easy as far as pushing the payload. So they hopefully can do so in quicker amount of time. So I've got this little bit of downtime here. What do you think is going to be important for them to be able to push the payload and capture the point quicker than the enemy team?
I think what's going to be important is what did them in a couple of battles there is the Reaper going off on his own to the side did them in quite a bit, and not keeping tabs on keeping their healers alive. Keeping the healers alive is gonna do wonders. Alright, so here we go into the first attack. We can see Stony Brook's taking a little bit of a different position than LR did.
Mm-hmm.
Where are they? They're all hiding right here except for their healers.
Yep.
Looks like Olivia and Azurum go down right off the bat. They do get a pick on
Sean
the Reaper.
His mech suit there too.
That's going to push LR back for another push. Sorry about that. I need to make a quick change. All right. Sorry about that. Here we go. Looks like LR is doing a bit better of a job here. Andy, 3 go down there. 4, 5, and it looks like Alec is the only one left. I actually don't know where he's at.
I believe he's hiding. Waiting for his team to regroup here, further back towards his pawn, just trying to get a couple of picks. Yeah, there he is. He ran back to heal. One good part is that Boop is getting close to his ult, so if they can get that transcendence off and get onto the point, they can maybe earn themselves a little bit of extra time.
Yeah.
But they're already lacking in time here.
Right.
At this point, they don't even care about getting it quicker. They just care about getting to the point.
Right.
They can't get out of the choke point, and that's a big issue there.
Yep. That was a team kill there. LR needs to reset. They have just under 2 minutes remaining. I think their biggest issue is this Reaper coming in and just getting right in their faces, mm-hmm. off from the side.
I think it's... Honestly, I'm not necessarily shocked, but at the same time, I'm I'm curious as to why they've remained with some, I guess, further distance DPS in Ashe and not switched off to someone a little bit more close range. I can understand the ult potential, and maybe that's why. Maybe he's waiting just to get Bob this first time, and then maybe he's tending to switch off, you think?
Probably, I would think so. But yeah, they are definitely struggling to get past that choke point and deal with that Reaper and Ana combo.
Yeah. That is tough. Whenever you get an Ana that can consistently
just
heal a team
people.
And then sleep and then just keep that high damage up, it instantaneous. Five of them go down.
Yep. And there's six. Just under a minute left in the map here.
I think maybe they'll get one more push out of this.
Possibly. It'll probably be the last push here.
Let's see. It looks like we have a push on the lower left here. Trying to catch him off guard, but the Ana's ready for it.
Mm-hmm. There's the Transcendence coming out there.
Yeah, trying to make sure they don't lose their time.
They do
here.
Got three down there.
That's good. Oh, man.
And that Reaper ultimate just comes in again and puts in tons of work.
Sean goes down, loses his mech suit. He does
get the ult off. Doesn't get anything, though.
No. This is not good for the Bears. They have 2 seconds.
I don't think, yeah, they're not going to get it.
It was worth a try.
Yep, and that's going to be the end of
map one.
The end of map one there. LR does take a loss for the map, but they still have time to turn it around.
Indeed. And I think this second map will definitely be more interesting.
Yep. And apparently textures just aren't going to load right now.
Yeah. There we go.
But we can see the enemy, Reinhardt, just putting in a ton of work there.
Looks like Vinny getting some good heals in, though, for our team, doing 30%. 30% or more is always good for a healer.
Mm-hmm.
That just sucks that they couldn't stay alive long enough to make that worth it.
Yep. And I'm sure knowing Keenan, he probably wasn't too far behind in...
Of course, yeah.
In percentage.
I feel like LR always does a little bit better job on the control maps anyway.
Yeah.
Anytime
that
I've seen them have to push a payload, they seem to have a hard time getting there.
Yeah.
But to be fair, every team has their strengths and weaknesses. So.
Right. Looks like the next map is going to be a control map, the Oasis map. I would need to check the record, but I believe they have the best, or at least a better win rate on control maps versus payloads. If we do.
We're checking with our tech supervisor right now.
Control maps versus payload?
While we await an official result, the game begins. I always love how creative players can get with their gamer tags. it just amazes me.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Ooh, looks like LR is pretty even in terms of their performance. I was mistaken. Okay. So this should be a pretty good game for LR, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Or map, rather, not game.
Yeah.
I would definitely be glad to see this go into a third map.
Oh, absolutely.
Have a great tight matchup there.
I think that would make many people happy. unlike the Super Bowl.
Yeah, unlike the Super Bowl.
Rather have a close match.
Yeah. Sorry, guys, we don't have any halftime shows for you. Not today. Maybe another day.
So it looks like LR is going to keep mostly the same comp. We're going to see we're going to see Badger switch from Ash onto McCree, and Keenan from Zenyatta onto Brigitte.
Interesting.
Maybe it looks like more aggressive push. Looks like Sony Brook's actually going to pull out a Bastion here.
Yeah.
I'm interested to see how that's going to work out for them. Just going to set up right there in front of the point. LR is going to push into the hallway here.
Yeah. They were ready for the push from the right side that time. But I think
Sorry, you got a big lag spike there.
Yeah.
And that Orisa is doing a good job keeping that Bastion just covered in shields. Andy does go down there to the Bastion.
But looks like the Genji goes down for the enemy team as
Genji
well.
Genji does go down. Keenan gets the Genji there. Man, these controls are really bad. These spectator controls
are terrible. I'm not going to lie, this is not really what I expected when I first saw this comp to begin with. Seeing the Reinhardt combined with the Zarya was nice. Obviously, anytime you see a Ryan and a Zarya together is fun. But
yeah.
When I saw Brigitte, I really thought they were going to go for the flank. Maybe they just decided to abandon it for now.
Until they can deal with...
Yeah. I will say that it just kind of worked out perfectly for Stony Brook that they managed to grab an Orisa and a Bastion on the same round that we were going to try to flank.
Yeah.
Had they simply just had a Bastion and had a Reinhardt instead of Orisa, we might have had a better chance at that flank.
There goes the support ult. Azurum does go down there to the Bastion. That's going to be the Bastion ult and Genji ult both come out there. Genji doesn't get anyone, but Bastion takes out the majority of the team there.
That was tough for the Bears. I lost 5 people.
Yep. That's going to be their biggest challenge, is getting around that Orisa shield.
Mm-hmm.
Because everyone else on that team is going to be supporting for that Bastion, trying to keep him alive.
Of course, yeah. Bastion's great at ripping through tanks. And if
right, through shields and through tanks.
If they can get that Genji on the flank while the Bastion's laying in from the front, I don't think the Bears will stand much of a chance unless they get around it, like you said.
Right.
You did see Deku switch off to Junkrat here, though. So
just trying to spam some grenades in over that barrier there.
Try to get rid of that barrier from afar before they push in. Very smart move by the Bears.
Mm-hmm. There goes a D.Va ult, and it looks like it's going to get
at least two.
Two there. Yeah. Both tanks go down, so does Andy.
Leaving just the supports in
that
the way.
That Bastion just was able to tear through the Reinhardt shield.
Yeah.
99%, and that I don't think LR is going to be able to get back in time.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's going to be the end of the round there.
They're just having a hard time coordinating their pushes, I think, because it seems like every time that they go to push, the enemy team's ready for it. I'm surprised to see the switch. Okay, never mind. He switched back. I was going to say, I'm surprised to see the switch to Lucio there by Boop, but he switched back to Brigitte, so.
Looks like Stony Brook is going to keep with the same comp. Just about, they're going to switch. Forget what they were playing before. They're
the
pulling
one
out the Torbjorn and Symmetra. They're going.
Yeah.
Oh wait, no, they switched back to an Ana.
Okay, so they still have the Ana Lucio comp.
But they are running a Symmetra, which is just gonna.
That's just gonna kill them on the flanks.
Yep. Set up those turrets that slow you down.
They are really trying to make sure that LR cannot make use of their DPS.
Right.
And they're getting rid of those tanks, as you said before.
Shredding those tank shields.
At any point, do you think that LR will abandon the Reinhardt and switch to perhaps another Orisa, to an Orisa of their own?
I don't know if they'd switch to an Orisa. If anything, I think we would probably see.
Do you think you see
maybe
a Winston?
Maybe a Winston or a Roadhog switch from Sean here.
I'm curious to see if, like you said, if they do switch to a Winston and they pull out a dive comp to try to get around those shields.
Oh man, I am apologizing for these lag spikes. It's like Olivia's the only one left right now. She is on the point.
Trying to stay alive. Doing everything she can.
She she's going to back up to try and get back with the team, but gets taken out by the enemy Lucio.
Mm-hmm. Once again, Boop is switched back to Zenyatta. Maybe a little bit more comfort from his perspective as the Zenyatta.
Now, I also don't think that they saw the Symmetra turret get set up here. There we go, they saw it.
It's also interesting that Azurum has switched to Winston now, like we mentioned before. Perhaps they do try a dive here. They don't really have much more to go with it.
And there goes the Symmetra ultimate. This barrier here has, what, 5,000 health?
I think it's 10,000.
10,000 health?
Yeah, I believe it's 10,000.
So five times what Reinhardt's shield is.
Yes.
Looks like Badger does get around. Didn't mean to do that.
And they do take out Ana.
He does take out the Ana.
That's really good for the bears. Perhaps Winston can dive on here.
There's a Diva ult coming out. Doesn't get anyone because everyone else got taken out first. Deshaun gets booped off the edge, and Boop gets taken out by the Bastion. Olivia gets taken out again by the Lucio, and Deku goes down to the Symmetra turret.
And little does Badger know, he just ran right into a trap there.
Yep, he does take out the enemy Symmetra, but gets taken out by the Orisa there.
Enemy team, once again, basically dominating this point. And the Bears will have one last chance to get on. There's the Hanzo ult trying to block off the right flank.
I think it's just a little bit too little too late there.
I believe so.
Eller just didn't have an answer to that Bastion.
He did not. So that'll be the end of game one of the evening.
That'll be the end of game one of the evening. Looks like the enemy Bastion does get play of the game here.
To be fair, this is well-deserved. Granted, I will say that the enemy team did an excellent job of keeping him protected so that he could do this.
Right.
But well-deserved play of the game by Skybox Bastion.
So, looks like Olivia there heals for 45% of all the damage that LR took in that match.
That was pretty amazing.
Yep. So, the next match here starts at 8:30 in just over an hour. We will see you at that time. We will start the stream back up. And go Bears.